And we are now joined by USC's Isaiah Mobley, who is coming off a big night as the Trojans knocked off UC Irvine tonight. Isaiah, what's going on, man? How you doing? Thanks for being here.
I'm doing well. Happy to be here. Happy to get the W tonight.
So you guys are sitting here at 11-0 right now. A lot of people are talking about UCLA. A lot of people are talking about Arizona. It doesn't feel like people are kind of paying attention to you guys sitting here, you know, number 10 of the country, undefeated. Do you guys feel that? Do you feel like you're being overlooked right now?
Somewhat, but I mean, it's a little bit out of our control, so we just try to keep on getting better day in and day out, try to keep on winning. And then if we keep on winning and get to number one, I guess people will know about us.
All right, we got to ask you this right out of the gates. We were talking off air. Who wins? You are against Evan one-on-one. Make it, take it to 11.
It honestly depends on the day.
Coach Enfield's refereeing.
That means no fouls, number one. number two, I think it depends on the day. My jumper's going. I think it's going to be tough for him. His jumper's going is going to be definitely tough for me. We got to see, especially because, I don't know, I've gotten a lot better over this season, and I'm sure he's gotten a lot better over the seasons as well. So, in the summer, we'll definitely get those matchups, and we could tell you guys for sure then.
Does he come up after games? Like, are you guys able to – is he still watching? Is he still locked in?
He watches all the time. Like, if they're not playing, obviously. They play – like, we had a little overlap tonight, so I would guess that he's seen the second half. And then I obviously watch his games. And we call, we critique each other. I tell him, like, bring it up sometimes. He tell me, you should have shot this. Like, it's like, just like kind of like how we were when we were here together.
Cleveland's off to a great year. I think they're fourth in the East right now.
No, yeah.
Isaiah, I got a question for you. Your dad's obviously a coach. You get the pleasure of being able to play for your dad, him being on that staff, but you can see it in your game. I think one of the most underrated qualities about that, about your game, is your ability to pass the ball. I mean, you've rebounded really well. You've scored it really well. How has your dad influenced you when it comes to, I mean, just your basic understanding for the game?
No, he influenced me a lot. So ever since I was a young kid, he's always told me, like, when I get the rebound, push it up. And then if there's someone ahead, obviously kick it ahead. And then just, like, because he's, like, a coach and understanding, like, plays and, like, why we run them, what we're looking for when we do, like, just concepts and stuff, I kind of have a good feel of, like, where people are going to be at, where they're open. And I always had, like, an infatuation about passing. I love guys like Magic Johnson, Jokic, things like that, because, number one, I feel like it gets a team involved and it takes a team to win. And also, like, being able to that pass threat kind of opens me up as well.
So you mentioned earlier that you've gotten a lot better in the offseason. You're averaging basically 15, 10, 3 assists, 41% from the three-point line. Where do you think specifically you've improved the most?
All around, like, I feel like my body's better. My understanding of the concepts is better. I'm in better shape. Shooting the three a lot better. And, like, my free throws aren't quite to where I want them to be, but they've gotten better. Like, this offseason I took very serious. I almost left USC going in and doing in the combine and stuff. But playing against those guys – who are pros definitely help elevate my game, I feel like. And just, like, also, like, learning the game, like, learning the pro styles and learning how I can incorporate them into college and stuff, because it's a little different game. But at the end of the day, like, objectives, put the ball in the bucket and stop the other team at doing it. So I feel like I've like, elevated all around, and also just my mindset and maturity. That was, like, probably the biggest thing, knowing when to be aggressive, knowing when to try to get other guys involved, like, playing the end game, not just pressing for points or pressing for rebounds and stuff like that.
What do you think – you guys obviously undefeated right now, but for you guys to make a great run in the Pac-12 and be right in the thick of things to win the league, you know, the last week of the regular season, what are one or two things that you guys got to continue to really focus on and improve on as a team?
Number one, our urgency, like, keeping it consistent. I feel like tonight we came out well. Then they got caught up. They got ahead. And second half, we came out well. And then we obviously stuck it out. But just, like, not playing down to the level. Like, they're a mid-major team. So, but, like, we can't take that lightly, because obviously they're good. They're beating us and beating us, like, for real, like, not by 2 and 4 points. Like, they got up to 10 at one point. So, not taking teams lightly. And also just, like, breathing confidence into everyone, because it's going to take everyone. Like, lately, like, I've got it going. Zvezda stepped up big tonight. Like the next game, it could be Ethan, it could be Max, it could be anyone on our roster. So just like keeping our skills sharp, because like it's going to take all of us. Like I know I had a solid year last year, but in the tournament, I was able to step up and to kind of help us get to that Elite Eight run. And so this year, if we want to make a further run, it's going to take all of us.
All right, Isaiah, we're gonna end it with this. You're shooting 41% from three this season. You shot 44% from three last season. If we lined up the racks right now and you took five shots from each of the five spots, you and Coach Enfield, who wins that three-point shooting contest?
That's a good one. Coach is a great shooter. I will say if it's today, I think I'll win just because I practice a little more. And, like, Coach still shoots around and stuff, but I never, ever in my whole 3 years here, I've never seen him shoot a three. He'll shoot, like, mid-range. He'll go, like, I'll count even sometimes, 10 for 12, just, like, before practices. And he rarely misses. But I never, ever, ever see him shoot a three-pointer. So just because of that, and I work out daily, I think I can get him on the three-point shots.
That's how they get you. Yeah. That's how they get you right there. They bait you into it. Mid-range jumpers, and then they'll get you one day.
No, definitely. Free throws, though, I think he might have.
Well, listen, Isaiah, we appreciate the time, man. Thank you for being here and congrats on the win tonight.
Thanks, Isaiah. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.